minutes because I think we're going to be running out of time, so we won't have much time left. So I'll try to make it to the point as much as possible. So first of all, Microsoft Dynamics is the range of Microsoft business solutions that includes ERP and CRM. We already had a session on ERP around 30 minutes ago. This session will be around CRM. So CRM is the customer relationship management application. And currently we're running on CRM 2011, which is the latest version of Microsoft CRM. So CRM touches on three main business areas. It covers sales, marketing, and service. So if you're into any kind of business, I'm sure that you have a sales engine in place, you have sales people to manage, they have quota, they need to get numbers, etc. Probably also you need to do some marketing activities, probably you launch new products, new services, you have events, you send email campaigns, etc. So any kind of email activity, any kind of marketing activity that you do also would be managed within CRM. And then the service part is when you're offering your customers after sales services. So for example, customers are coming back with complaints, with the warranty services, with the service level contracts, with extended warranty, etc. Any kind of services that you'd offer to your customers after the sale has been done will be also covered under the service model. CRM exists on a desktop, of course, it's a web application, so it can be accessed through any web interface. Also, we do have lots of mobile interfaces, so whether you're using a Windows Phone, Android, iPhone, BlackBerry, any kind of mobile device, an HTML-enabled device can also access CRM. And of course, tablets. So we do have a Windows 8 tablet, we do have a client for iOS, for iPad, so we also have lots of tablet clients available in the market. And CRM is all about managing relationships, interactions, ways of communication between you and your customers, whether this is by phone, by email, by SMSs, even social, which I will discuss in a few minutes. You can also automate all processes in CRM because it has its own built-in workflow engine. And of course, you can get lots of BI and reports from CRM. Also, we do exist on-premise and in the cloud. So if you want to have the classic way of applications on your premise, on your server, of course, we do offer that. If you want to go with the trend now, everybody's moving to the cloud, etc. So you want to have it in the cloud, we do also have an offering in the cloud. The last part that I'd like to cover is the extended CRM. Sometimes we refer to it as extended CRM, sometimes we refer to it as XRM. So what is XRM? XRM is simply either extended relationship management or X, like we use it in algebra. So for example, X plus Y, remember those old days? X is for anything relationship management. So what does that mean in the business world? For example, let's say you're into the construction business, construction industry. How many customers would you have on your list? Maybe 5, 10, 20, 50? Not hundreds, not thousands, as the nature of the business. So for a construction company, they're not really keen to manage the customers. Of course, they do want to manage customers, but I mean, it's not a complicated process for them. However, for them, they want to manage subcontractors, they want to manage vendors, they want to manage consultants, because actually the one who gets the business for a construction company is the consultant. So for them, they want to manage consultants. So it's not a typical customer relationship application, that could be a consultant relationship management application, or a vendor, or a subcontractor. So that's why we came up with the X concept, or the XRM, or the extended relationship management. So let me share with you a few screenshots that will highlight the main, that will give us the highlights of the product. First of all, as you can see here, it's highly productive. So why are we saying it's highly productive? Probably you can notice that this is Outlook, but also it covers CRM. So we do have a client from within Outlook itself. So CRM is a web application. However, if you want to use it from within Outlook, we do have a full client from within Outlook. What does that mean for you? If you have people who really resist new technology, who wants to just use the technology that they're used to, they don't want to learn any new technology, they don't want to get training, etc. So for them, it would be the normal Outlook interface. But from within Outlook, they have full access to CRM. They can manage their opportunities, their needs, their marketing campaign, their customer service request from within Outlook itself. And of course, it's fully integrated with Outlook. So let's say I want to send my customer a quotation. I want to send him the latest brochure for my product, etc. I just click send automatic to go from my CRM to Outlook to my customer. If the customer will reply and say I'm interested, it will come from Exchange to Outlook to CRM. So it's a full cycle between Exchange, Outlook, and CRM, fully integrated together. Same applies to meetings, to tasks, to calendar, anything that they would like to trigger from CRM to Exchange is fully integrated. The second benefit of the Outlook client is the offline use. So the same way that we use Outlook in offline mode, so let's say today you're sitting here in the Open Doors event, let's say you don't have access to the internet, you can still open Outlook and access all your email offline. Same applies to the Outlook client for CRM. So let's say you're a salesperson sitting with a customer somewhere without an internet connection, you can still open the Outlook client for CRM, access everything you want to see about this customer offline. You can even work offline. Create a quotation, do whatever you want offline. Once you're back online, everything will sync with as well. Also, CRM has its own built-in dashboard engine. You can create any kind of dashboard on the fly within CRM, whether this dashboard is around marketing, sales, services, XRM, across the whole applications, across the whole process, you can easily create this dashboard. You don't need to have a developer, you don't need to have any IT background. I always give this example. If you're able to create a chart in Excel, you can create a dashboard in CRM. It's as simple as that. You just pick the data that you want, how do you want it to look like. Next, you have a dashboard ready. Let's say I'm a sales manager, I want to create a dashboard that will make sense to my business, and I want to automatically assign it to all my sales people. I want them to have access to the same view, but from their own angle. I create the dashboard and say assign to my team. Full stop, once they open the CRM, they see the dashboard reflecting their own numbers and their own territories, etc. It's fully connected with Link. So for those of you who attended the last session on Microsoft Link, CRM is fully integrated with Link. So for example, you can see the status of your colleagues, even your customers, if they're using the same technology. I can chat with them, I can have a voice call with them, video call, etc. Of course, it's integrated also with the mapping application, whether this is Bing Maps, Google Maps, any kind of mapping application, it can be fully integrated. So for example, this can help me with planning my sales journey. So I'm a salesperson, I need to meet today 10 different customers. Who should I start with? Probably I need to start with the 3-4 customers around me in the same district, and then go to the industrial zone, and then go to the city, etc. So this even can help me with my planning, my sales journey. We do have also a very interesting concept, which is the what's new. Same concept like Facebook. So if you have a Facebook account, which I assume all of you have a Facebook account, same concept of wall. So once you go to the wall, on your wall on Facebook, you can see that your friend posted this photo, this friend posted this article, this friend likes this video, this friend is making fun of that person, etc. So you can see everything in one single place, right? And it keeps updating all the time. Same applies to CRM. So the what's new is your wall where you can follow anything around your business. So I can, for a salesperson, I can follow all my customers. For a customer service person, he can follow all the complaints coming from the customer, the suggestions, the inquiries, etc. For a marketing person, he or she can follow all the different campaigns on the system. So once any campaign or customer or product gets updated, automatically I will see it on my wall, which is what's new. So I don't need to go and open a new window or inquire or do a certain inquiry. It's all coming automatically. All the feeds are coming to my wall without me opening different windows or screens. As I mentioned earlier, we have a mobile client. So for example, this is how it would look on the iPad. We do have lots of clients on different mobility platforms. So CRM. As I mentioned, covers marketing, sales, service. We have the XRM piece as well as described earlier. You can capture any kind of communication between you and your customers, whether this is by email, phone, fax, face-to-face, web, etc. All these different types of communications will be captured from the same application, whether SMSs, any kind of communication that you can think of. So the main idea of having one single integrated application from all business aspects, from all communication channels, is to get a 360-degree customer view, or a single view, or know your customer. Each and every one of us will have a different name for that. But simply, it's one single place where you can go and know exactly every single thing that happened with your customers. So my customer is interested in this product. My customer made an inquiry about this product 2 months ago. This customer said that our prices are high. This customer really likes our technology. This customer is complaining. This customer is X, Y, Z. Everything for me as a customer representative or a relationship manager or a salesperson is in one single screen. How can this help me? It can help me, for example, in cross-selling and upselling. If I know that my customer has bought product X, Y, and Z, maybe automatically I know that this customer, since he bought these products, is also eligible to get this product, or he'd be interested to buy this product. What if I want to upsell? So he used to have this product for the past 3 years. He never complained about it. He's a loyal customer. Let me upgrade him. Let me give him a better product, for example, free of charge or with a promotion. So having one single view helps you to understand better your customer, hence providing him with better services and improving the relationship, which is why we need a CRM, to improve the relationship. Just quickly taking over the modules that we have. So in the marketing module, so what can you do in the marketing module? Let's say I have tens of customers, hundreds of thousands of customers. I want to filter my customers based on a certain campaign. Let's say I'm running a campaign for Ramadan. I'm offering the latest Kia car 10% off, just a promotion for Ramadan. I need to go through my contacts list and do a certain criteria. So I need to have all the people who are living in Kuwait and this city who have 2 cars, who have 4 children, and that these will be interested in my new SUV, or my new 4x4. So I pick my criteria in CRM. As you can see, the criteria is very easily configured, as if you're doing a filter in Excel. The same simplicity. So I pick my criteria. Once I'm done with my criteria, I save it, and then I pick the channel. This can be an email. Once I choose email, automatically it will be sent from CRM to Outlook to Exchange. And once I get a reply from my customer, automatically it will be captured within the same loop. Let's say I have a promotion for my VIP customers. So I will not send them an email. I will go and meet them face to face. I'll just pick appointment. Automatically this will create an appointment for me on my calendar or my salesperson, who probably reports to me. And also it will send a meeting request to my customers. So again, the whole cycle is closed between Exchange and CRM. Or probably I would like to send it to my call center people who need to call all the customers. So automatically I pick phone call, and then this will create a task on each and every single call center agent that he needs to call this customer concerning this product or this promotion or whatever message I want to give to my customers. So the benefit of having one single tool handling all my marketing communication is that I can, for example, get a report telling me how effective were my campaigns, or probably which activity had the best return. For any marketing person, probably if any of you do marketing, they're really keen to know the ROI on their campaigns. So for example, to get a budget on a certain campaign, let's say they go to their management, to the GM, and say, I want to run this campaign, it will cost me 5,000 KD. Okay, so the management will ask, what will be the return on that? If he doesn't have the return, he cannot get the budget, as simple as that. So the management will tell him, okay, get the 5 KD, but I need it. Against that, 50,000 KD. Can you confirm that? Can you ensure that? So this management guy or person, he needs to have such a tool to make sure that he is able to measure what kind of return I'm getting on my campaign. So this is very important tool for a typical marketing person. Also, we do have the event management part in CRM. So, for example, for Microsoft to manage such an event, we need to have a tool. Who would be attending, who would be speaking, what kind of giveaways are we doing, what kind of agenda, the sponsors, etc. So we do have also a tool to manage all this. For example, we can also publish the invitation of Open Doors event on the portal. So you can go on Microsoft portal or in any website and say, yes, I'm interested, I will register. This is my information, so somebody probably can call you 2 days before the event just to confirm that you're done. Also, a very interesting new concept that a lot of customers now are adopting is what we call e-marketing or smart marketing. What does that mean? I'm sure that you all get lots of newsletters and email campaigns to your mailbox. The first time you will get an email, most of the images will appear in Excel, right? Once you add this sender, the safe sender, or whatever the name is, the next time all the images will load. These images are not coming. These images will know that you open this newsletter and that you click on a certain link, and automatically this input will go back to CRM. So once you open a newsletter, even without doing anything, I know already that you opened my email, and you probably just move with your mouse on a certain image for a couple of seconds, and probably move to another image for 2 minutes. I can gather this intelligence inside Microsoft, and I know that person X, he opened my email and did nothing. Person Y opened my email and clicked on that link. Or person Z opened that email and did whatever. So all this intelligence is coming back to my CRM, and I can know exactly how can I communicate with my customer in a smarter way, probably the next time. If you don't accept it the first time as a receipt. Yeah, that's the feature of Outlook. So Outlook, once you accept it the first time, Outlook will tell you, by the way, now you're given access order. There's a certain message that you get that you're exposing some things on your Outlook to external sources. So if you disable this, they will never be able to, they will block it. Outlook will block it, exchange will block it. But you can't see the images. Yeah, so the images is the incentive that we give to the target to open the email. If he's not really interested, because from the title he knows that this is a target, for example, a real estate company, and I don't have any interest to buy real estate, I will just delete the email. But if it's around, for example, a nice trip to the Maldives, and I'm really planning something, I'm very keen to open the email to see what kind of offers they have. Okay, so once you're done with your marketing activities, hopefully you start generating leads, and then the sales engine will kick off. So I can manage my leads in CRM, so I can capture any kind of information. I can manage my accounts later on. Also, we do have the relationship management part within CRM, which is very important. So for example, I know that Ahmed is related to Muhammad, and Muhammad and Ahmed are the sons of Mr. X, and Mr. X is the husband of Mrs. Y, etc. So all this relationship might be very important for certain businesses. So for example, in the banking space, let's say I know that Mr. Muhammad is a very loyal customer for me. He opened his account 15 years ago. He's a great customer, etc., etc. I can also keep track in CRM. He has two children. One of them will turn 18 next month. So probably before he turns 18, I'll just send him a complimentary credit card for his son. So that, of course, shows how close I am to my customer. And of course, it's a new chance for me to generate more profit from his son, because definitely his son will be very happy with his credit card, and he will go and use it. So all these things are mainly based on relationships. So a CRM is a typical tool to manage all these relationships for you. If I want to profile my contacts, so I want to know whatever the kind of profile that I want. If I even want to customize the whole list, I want to add more fields, remove fields, you can easily do that without any developer, without any coding. Loyalty is a very important piece of any CRM. So now everybody, all the retailers, all the big names, Carrefour, Sultan, you name it, are very keen to make sure that you're loyal to them. So now they issue loyal cards. They give you points whenever you buy anything. If you buy yogurt, you buy a TV, you buy a milk, you buy anything, automatically you start getting points, and then you become probably a silver customer, a platinum, a gold, whatever, and then you start redeeming your points. So you need also to have an engine in place to manage this. How are you giving points to your customers? How are you giving them different deals? And how are you redeeming their points? So this is a typical also module within CRM. And then the customer service part. So the customer service has different ends. Of course, you can still generate your dashboard, etc. You can even have more analysis for the customer trends, how many people have raised, for example, complaints the last week, how many of them are resolved, etc. So all these different trends you can easily get out of the system. Again, the same what's new from a customer service perspective. A complete case management engine. So any request or any inquiry or any complaint I get, automatically to be logged in CRM as a case. This case can be a sales inquiry, this case can be a customer complaint, this case can be an escalation, can be a thank you note, can be anything. Each one of these would follow a different workflow or different routing mechanism. So for example, a sales inquiry I will send to the salespeople, a complaint I will send to the customer service representative, a thank you note I will send it to my customer service manager, whatever. So all these can follow different business logics or different processes. Of course, we do have more than 42 languages covered by the system. Arabic is one of them, out of the box, free of charge, as you can see for the Arabic-speaking audience. We do also have the scheduling module within CRM. So let's say I'm selling electronics, so a customer would call me 2 weeks after he bought his new TV, and then I have a problem with my TV, he sends someone to fix it. I go and check his contract, if he's covered with warranty, etc. And then I need to check who would be eligible, who's ready, help him with his latest plasma screen. So the system can get me all the engineers, all the technicians who are probably trained on that TV. I can see the availability coming from Microsoft Outlook or Exchange, see that X is available tomorrow morning, and just go and block his calendar. This automatically will go to my technician's calendar. I will send a meeting request to Microsoft or an SMS or any kind of communication. As I mentioned, you can manage the contracts, the service agreements, the warranties also in CRM. Another interesting tool that we have is the guided dialogue. So guided dialogue is simply call scripted. Okay, what does that mean? Let's say you have a call center, or even you have normal sales engine where your salespeople have to call the customers. But you're very keen that the salespeople will always follow the same script. So if you call the customer, you need to greet the customer, good morning, Mr. Muhammad, how are you, etc., etc. And then you have a certain pitch. So are you interested in this product? If yes, then there's another question. If no, there's another question. So if you have this project in place, you can easily automate it on CRM. So CRM will come up with you with questions based on the answers. So this will make sure that if your customer would call you 100 times, he will have exactly the same experience, which is based on your policy or based on your spirit. So not every single agent will just come up with the question based on his how he feels on this day. It has to follow exactly a certain script in a professional way, and it has to be enforced on the agent. Also, this can help you in a different way, because this project can be smart enough to pop up questions for you to cross-sell and upsell. So for example, if the flow of answers is going in a certain direction, automatically the system will come and tell you, by the way, this customer should be interested also in product Y. So please pitch it to him. This customer will be interested in an extended service one. This customer is interested in X, Y, Z. So the system also can be smart enough to help the agents, the sales agents or the customer service agents, to come up with new products and services to the customers. So as I mentioned earlier, we have different ways of communication. The most important one on this slide for me is social. So now everybody wants to go social. So now we all have social accounts, whether Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, LinkedIn, any kind of social activity. Now also all the companies in the market, they want to do this. So I want to reach my customers on Facebook, on LinkedIn, on Twitter, on YouTube, on MySpace, whatever. So for example, if I have, again, the same example, I have a credit card for 18 people, 18-year-old youth. So how would be the best way to target this audience? Probably Facebook. An 18-year-old person will not be on Twitter, because they will not be on LinkedIn, because it's not working yet. Probably he's always with his friends, etc. So what would be the best way, what would be the best place to find them? On Facebook. So if I have a nice page on Facebook, what about I can start doing promotions and sending it to all the people living in Kuwait between, for example, 80 and 20. This would be the best way of doing that. So how can we do that? By having a CRM package fully integrated to all the social networks. If I have another promotion that I want to run to all lawyers in Kuwait, what would be the best channel? LinkedIn. I can easily go on LinkedIn in 2 seconds, get all the business of professionals working as a lawyer in law firms in Kuwait. Pushing for them certain communications, or even once they respond to me, automatically this will go to CRM as a new lead or a new lead. Yeah. So social now is becoming a very hot trend. If I want to expose CRM to the portal where customers can go and update their profiles, schedule the service, etc., all this is also available. So BI, you can create your dashboard, you can create your own reports, you can drill down into reports, you can even get advanced BI advanced analysis. So again, all this is based on the SQL layer, because CRM sits on SQL, and SQL of course is very rich when it comes to BI. We're running out of time, so I just need to move a little bit fast if you don't mind. So we do have the workflow engine, which is across the whole application. The workflow engine doesn't require any development. You can write it as if you're doing an if statement in Excel. So if this event happens, then do this. If not, do that. Simple as that. If you still want to make it more complicated with development, you can extend it easily using .NET. But I mean, in most of the cases, you can really write a very comprehensive workflow without a single line of code. On the call center side, if you have a call center in place, CRM is integrated with all these different telephone providers, and of course, with Microsoft Link as well. For the Windows 8, I'm sure that you've all seen Windows 8, so also we do have a client for CRM on Windows 8, so this is how it would look like. You can start the call with your customer from within the application. This can be connected to Link, for example, and the call automatically will be started from Link. I can create opportunities on the application. I can even check, for example, for the customer context on LinkedIn. System automatically will go on LinkedIn and tell me if I'm connected to this customer or not on LinkedIn or Facebook or Twitter, etc. I can create my proposals from within CRM with predefined templates. These templates can be in English and Arabic. I can have a template for my key customers, for my other customers. And finally, these are some of our references on a worldwide scale. And then these are again some of our references on a regional scale in the Gulf. Some of them in this region are in Kuwait. I mean, there's Burgan Bank. And also we have KFH, who's currently implementing CRM in Kuwait, and there's also CDK. Again, in addition to many other big names, for example, Qatar Airways, Bahrain Logistics Committee, many other names across the region who are using the same technology. I'm sorry if I had to make it very fast, but again, because of the time constraints, I'm sorry for that. So that was my last slide, and of course I can get to take any questions if you have any. So you do have access as a thin client that's already available from Microsoft free of charge. You can have a version of CRM sitting on your own phone. That's a thin client that's available free of charge from Microsoft. If you're looking for an app to sit on your operating system, whether Android or iOS or BlackBerry, this is available too.
Have you seen the latest social, the auto connector?
So there's an outlet connector, social outlet connector, available free of charge. You can find it online. Once you have downloaded that, this will give you full integration between Outlook and all the social networks. Exactly. So if you're using Outlook client, CRM client from within Outlook, you also can have the same social network. You can, but you need to build it. It will not be out of box in that case. So, but if you use the Microsoft connector, it's out of box. If not, then you need probably to build it because integration is a very vague word. Because when you need integration with Facebook, it can be different things for different people. So it's based on your exact scope, yes, it can be done. But the connector is already there, as I mentioned, and it's available free of charge for Outlook. And once you have the Outlook connector as well for CRM, then you can leverage this connector. Any other questions? Okay, thank you so much. So, as I mentioned, my name is Ahmed Salama. I'm based out of Dubai, but I cover the whole region. So, if you have any other inquiries, please let me know and I can give you my business card. Thank you so much.